road trip today. Today's video is sponsored by Sheetz. Just kidding. But Sheetz, if you're available, I mean, I'm down. Let's do something. Maryland. Virginia. Did I just get a number one? Could I get the waffle fries and a sweet tea? Couple notes. Number one, I've never been to DC before. The traffic is crazy. And I wasn't even in the city yet. I was just on the Beltway and it was nuts. Number two, we desperately need a Chick-fil-A in Kittanning, Pennsylvania. Somebody gotta make that happen. Lincoln Riddle, if you're watching, gas prices, Richmond, Virginia, $2.49. You're welcome. Just realizing I should probably show like all the home cooked food that I eat, because you guys are gonna start to think I eat like this all the time, since like whenever I'm on the road I just get fast food. But it's just an every now and again treat, but I can't pass up Chick-fil-A when I have the opportunity. It's too good. North Carolina. So 9 hours of driving later, I am in Smithfield, North Carolina. I'll tell you guys what I'm doing here in just a little bit, but have a group dinner tonight. Sheetz this morning, Chick-fil-A for lunch, and now Texas Steakhouse for dinner. Never experienced Texas Steakhouse, but I'll try to steal a couple pictures and then I'll get back to you once I get to the hotel. By the way, 88 degrees here at 6 p.m. Down south's a little bit different, I guess. So why am I in North Carolina? I am here for actually a study group on church planting. So I'm trying to come up with a model, a national model that could be used anywhere, small cities, medium-sized cities, big cities, on planting churches all across the United States. And so I'll tell you more about that tomorrow after we have kind of our big meeting and see what we come up with as far as conclusions on that topic. And hopefully I'll find some time to, and a cool place to fly the drone. But before I wrap this up, I know you probably saw in the car I had headphones in basically the entire journey. I never have signed up for Audible before, but I signed up for Audible this last week because I knew I had this big car ride and we're planning to go to Minnesota in the near future as well. So I'm going to have something like 48 hours in the car over the next few weeks. So I figured it'd be good to have some stuff to listen to. But the very first audiobook that I purchased was called Lost Connections by Johann Hari. And I've been wanting to read the book for a while, and I thought this would be a pretty good excuse for me to check it out. This book was absolutely incredible on checking out the causes and potential solutions for depression and anxiety. If you look at the rates of medication prescriptions and all those kinds of things in Kittanning and obviously all across our nation, it is at epidemic proportions. And when it came to the conclusion and potential solutions for depression and anxiety, I didn't really agree with that part of the book. There was a lot of socialistic tendencies to it, but the data and the stories at the beginning on how the prescription industry has actually kind of manipulated that whole epidemic is was really fascinating. Totally worth the price of the book by itself. And so if you are interested in that topic at all, and we're going to be talking about that hopefully a lot more in this channel, because I think it relates directly to the opioid problem, this book was absolutely amazing. I learned things like the depression scale is actually a score from 1 to 51, and so there's a big range there. The medications, the best medications on the market, have only found that they help on average 1.9 points on a 51-point scale. And so the medications are not helping. They're not solving the problem. Just getting better sleep can move you 6 points on the scale. Just being outdoors and being more connected with nature can move the scale four and a half points. So there are a myriad of causes. It could be childhood trauma, could be a lack of meaningful work, could be a breakdown in relationships. There are a multitude of different causes of depression that are laid out in the book, 9 different ones to be exact. But almost none of those are caused by what the medical community would tell us is the problem, which is a imbalance of chemicals in your brain. And so depression and anxiety are much less of a physical, chemical problem like we've been told that it is. It's much more of a social, relational, societal type problem. It's a loss of meaningful connection. And so we got to get those connections back. And like I said, I didn't necessarily agree with the conclusions, but check out the book if you're interested in the topic at all. I'll put an Amazon link in the description. Check it out on Audible. Audible's free for the first time around. So if you want to sign up for Audible, I can put that link in the description as well. You get your first book for free. So, I mean, if it's interesting to you, check it out. First 4 chapters just packed with data about the history of the medical community and the diagnosis of depression and anxiety and how that's been treated over time. Just super, super fascinating. But anyways, speaking of getting better sleep, I've been on the road 9 hours. I had some interaction tonight. I got my things here to study for my long day tomorrow. So I am going to do that. And the bed is calling my name. Nice hotel room though. Really nice place. Show you more of that tomorrow as well. All the things that you're supposed to do at the end of the video. You know the drill.